I'm gonna tell you about a modern pop star so versatile who's collaborated with the likes of Ice Age, Charlie XCX, Dive, The Jesus and Mary Chain, and Primal Scream. A modern pop artist who's had her foot in just about every door in the music industry and can adapt like clay to whatever role she chooses. Well, that pop star is very much real, and her name is Sky Ferreira. Sky Ferreira emerged as an artist in 2012 with her debut EP, Ghost, a body of synth-pop cuts and acoustic ballads. Collaborators included Dev Hines of Blood Orange, Shirley Manson from Garbage, John Brion, and Ariel Rexteed, who has produced the likes of Haim, Sia, and Charlie XCX. Ferreira amassed a cult following for her synth-pop hit Everything Is Embarrassing, with layered, airy vocals and infectious kick drum patterns. The EP also included acoustic ballads that were very stripped down, like Sad Dream and Ghost. A big standout track on that project is the Shirley Manson collaboration, Red Lips, a very 90s-esque pop rock track, where Ferreira delivers her most commanding vocals. But one of Ferreira's big shining moments that is worth acknowledging is her masterpiece of a debut album, one that she had to fight tooth and nail to get out, and that is Nighttime My Time. The album was a strong departure from the Ghost EP, a pop album that really stands out with effect Latin guitar, distortion, and elements of shoegaze, krautrock, and even electronic synth rock with cuts like 24 Hours, which sounds like a straight up suicide song. Diamonds are full of cool champagne. Sky Ferreira has had a particularly hard time navigating the music industry because she's unwilling to compromise her image or her vision. She's opened up about receiving media training and feeling disgusted with the idea of being told how to act. She refuses to play by the rules, and that type of woman is very easy for gatekeepers in the music industry to block from accomplishing many things. Because the music industry basically runs on a culture that ensures that women who don't follow the rules will be punished for it. I went from being at school to getting on airplanes to see various producers and kind of being whored around, you know? I did this to escape high school and got treated way worse. In fact, we wouldn't even have Nighttime My Time without Ferreira's vigilance and persistence. She ended up having to pay for the album herself with her savings that she'd earned from modeling gigs because her label would not get behind the project. The most commanding performances she gives on the album are Nobody Asked Me If I Was Okay and I Blame Myself. You can really feel the urgency and fervor in her voice on both of those songs. The latter is a song that grapples with Ferreira's experiences of sexual assault and the backlash that victims disproportionately face. I blame myself, how could you know what it feels like to fight the hounds of hell? You think you know me so well. The whole album is incredible front to back. Sky Ferreira has been on hiatus for around 7 years now, and Sky's sophomore album Masochism was slated to come out in 2016. But it's been delayed many times. She made a return with her most recent single, Downhill Lullaby, in 2019, which is slated to be on the new album. But now that we're all quarantined and in lockdown, she refuses to put out more music until she is able to perform live. That's just how she functions. and a lot of her fans have been disappointed by that, but that's how a lot of the most great artists out there work. Fiona Apple is still killing it in the digital age, and she's taken breaks that are just as long. When we look at the current culture around album releases now, it is a game that you can more easily get forgotten in if you're not keeping up to speed all the time. But how many artists can you name today who truly care this much about their art? It's something so sacred to them that they refuse to let anybody touch it until they are fully satisfied. I know that one day we will get new music from Sky, and I really hope that her fans can give her the same patience and support that she was willing to give herself. And she hasn't stopped working, by the way. She's been so busy with collaborations. I mean, there are so many modern pop artists today who are at the top of their game, but I can guarantee you none of them has gotten the call to work with the Jesus and Mary Chain. Sky's gonna be fine. And when she does finally come out with new music, it will be well worth the wait.